there's a special on Netflix that I just started checking out. It was like day before yesterday. It's called Extraordinary, the Stan Romanek story. And I'm watching it, and it's about this guy, Stan Romanek, and he's got this incredibly extraordinary footage, and this is like one of the things that he recorded, is like his famous footage right here. See that famous footage? So he wanted to catch the alien guy who was looking in through his window. Yeah, so he set up a camera.
And the second flash of light was so bright it almost blinded me, and I had the door almost all the way shut.
Okay.
It's like, holy crap.
Holy crap, big time.
And I kind of ducked back, and then I kind of looked again. I see this head pop down.
What?
It's like, yes, I got it.
It just looks like the fakest thing ever, and then he goes, oh my god, he jumps, like.
To see if I could see this guy, and I saw what I thought was a small child running toward the back.
Small child, eh? Well, anyways, I'm watching this with my friend. As we're watching it, I'm like, man, this guy's story is weird as hell, and he seems like a kind of a strange guy. I'm getting this vibe. It is not good. And I said to my friend even, I said, you know what would be, like, really messed up? If this guy actually was some kind of, like, you know, child predator, but, like, every time he went into his you know, child predator mode, that he thought he was being abducted by aliens. Like, that was, like, when you regress his memory, that was the memory that had replaced the traumatic experience of him, you know, being predatory or towards children, right? And I was just sort of joking about it, and then, you know, continue watching and whatnot, and here's just an excerpt from it here,
So I thought it was a full moon because I had a real good visual of this thing, whatever it is, and come to find out there was no full moon, so
no
might
full
have been something else over our house.
Something else over our house. Oh my goodness, could be true. I mean, I'm a believer. I'm a believer. I think there's other life forms out there, but I don't know about this guy.
Things over for sleep already. I didn't want him to get in trouble. And I woke up because I heard a noise. I had one eye open. And I'm sitting there going like this, and I see a naked figure run into my kitchen. I'm thinking, what in the heck is my stepson doing? I thought they, you know, his friends dared him to do something. I was going to go find my camera to blackmail him because I wanted to catch him on camera. I went upstairs.
Wait, what? You thought that your son was running around naked during a sleepover, so your first instinct was to get the camera and try and blackmail him? That's a little bit odd.
They were still asleep. I kind of woke one kid up, opening the door. I said, I heard a noise, and then went back to sleep.
Okay, so you broke into the kids' rooms while they were still sleeping, and one of them woke up for a quick second and said, I heard a noise. Okay, well, that's interesting. Considering this little tidbit here that's on Snopes, UFO enthusiast now facing child pornography charges is subject of Netflix documentary. So there's the guy right there, Stan Romanek. It says a prominent self-proclaimed alien abductee says his computer was hacked in a government conspiracy to silence him. So prominent 54-year-old UFO researcher, I'm going to turn this around and read this for you here. Prominent UFO enthusiast who claims to have been abducted by aliens several times is set to face trial in Colorado on charges of possession and distribution of child pornography. Romanek gained a certain newfound renown ahead of his 31st of July 2017 trial date when the Netflix released his feature-length documentary recounting 15 years worth of alleged extraterrestrial and supernatural encounters. It's called Extraordinary, the Stan Romanek story. It was originally made in 2013 by a Seattle director named John Sumple, but not added to Netflix until just this month. Which in turn exposed the documentary and the man to the streaming website's nearly 100 million subscribers. So yeah, there's a ton of people that have probably watched this thing. What, did you watch it? Did you see the thing? Did you watch the documentary called Extraordinary, the Stan Romanek story? What kind of vibe did you get off it? Let's see, it says the film series of vignettes without voiceover narration, all of which is presented as mesmerizing evidence dating back to 2000 in dozens of home videos, photographs, and interviews, often accompanied by dramatic classical music. Director John Sumple presents evidence of unidentified flying objects, sightings, encounters with little green men in Romanek's home, flying orbs, ghostly voices, and purported alien abductions that have brought him to public attention in the past. The body of evidence is primarily made up of easy to fake and even occasionally laughable images of aliens and mysterious faces appearing in backgrounds of photos, lights in the sky with mundane-like explanations, and standard material UFO hoaxes, lawn circles, abduction flashbacks revealed under hypnosis, and abduction wounds. Indeed, Romanek's claims have been challenged or debunked on a few occasions. In 2009, he was asked by ABC News to submit a purported alien implant in his leg to medical examination. When the time came, Romanek claimed it had disappeared from his body. The Rocky Mountain Paranormal Research Group recreated the famous video produced by Romanek purporting to show little green men peeking into his window. The group claims they reenacted the video for about $90. And in 2015, Romanek was forced to admit that he faked moving objects that appeared in the background of an earlier interview. In a further twist, he explained the hoax by claiming that the authorities had intimidated him into discrediting himself. And then I got some footage here from the trailer. This is the trailer for the Netflix thing we were watching there.
I am, but I can tell you that your perceptions of Stan Romanek and his experiences are real. The interesting thing is
All right, so a little bit weird that you saw there the algorithms and mathematics and whatnot. Apparently this guy, like, you know, after having been abducted, started just, you know, writing out all of these theories and algorithms and whatnot. And some people have verified them and said that, they have something to do with, some kind of like traveling beyond the speed of light type of mathematics. He calls himself Starseed. Several of these girls are very young and unmistakably children. So, yeah, it looks like he's going to have to go to trial on some child pornography charges. And, check out the Snopes page there. There's probably lots of other research to be done. But, have you seen this? Do you know about the Stan Romanek story? What kind of vibe did you get? Do you think this is all just a big government conspiracy to discredit the alien believers? Smash onto the like button for me. Find the subscribe button. Let me know if you like this kind of content. And if you like this story, give me a comment too. I will be back at it all the time.